What are some ideas for future research?
Well, these data show that there are a broad range of additional kinds of studies that really need to be done. These range from doing dosing studies, which enables us to figure out what's the best dose or the optimum dose in general for a given approach. Also a range of studies where you look to see if you can compare a given complementary health approach with conventional care or other types of complementary health approaches to get the best effect for a given type of patient themselves. There's also a broad range of mechanistic studies which need to be done to help us identify what are the most important components of the intervention so that they can be most easily practiced or performed with patients.
How can future research address needs of diverse populations?
So, looking at this study in diversity is really an important aspect of understanding how complementary health approaches specifically, but healthcare in general, how it differs across different racial, ethnic, and gender, as well as age groups. That is, it's not the case that just because you've shown a given approach works in one facet of the population that it's going to necessarily work the same or have the same benefits across all. So it really needs to be, studies need to be done that look at how these approaches are useful in all the different age range, so everything from pediatrics to young adults, older adults, and our most senior citizens, as well as across different ethnic and racial partitions within the country as well. We know that there are lots of reasons why people have these differences in terms of benefit, everything from the differences that make us up from our genomics all the way to cultural issues and how people value the care, the different types of care that are offered.
For more information, please visit nccih.nih.gov/pain_review.